sign, and we hope that you could understood the previous part of this unit, laws of motion. So today we are going to discuss about free body diagram. Okay, so what is meant by this free body diagram and why we are using this free body diagram? So this free body diagram is used to analyze the motion of the object using Newton's law. If an object is in motion and if you want to find out the force acting on it, we are using this free body diagram. Okay, using Newton's law, we will find out the force acting on it. Or if we know the force, we can find out the mass of the object. Or if we know the acceleration, we can find out the mass. If we know the acceleration and mass, we can find out the force. Similarly, using Newton's law, we are going to analyze the motion of the object. Okay, for this, we have to consider the object to be a point source. Okay. Suppose we are taking any of the object, edo or object edukrom, and we are going to analyze the forces acting on the object. Okay, not forces exerted by the object. This is very important point. While drawing the free body diagram, we have to consider the forces acting on the object, and no need to consider the forces exerted by the object. So these are the three steps to be followed by drawing the free body diagram. Okay, first one, identify the forces acting on the object. Okay, forces acting on the object, not by the object. Force and the object exert பண்ற force நம்ம பார்க்க கூடாது, அந்த ஆப்ஜெக்ட் மேல இருக்கிற force மட்டும் பார்க்கணும். Okay, second thing, represent the object as a point. Whatever the object may be, represent it as a is at a point. இந்த மாதிரி ஏதாவது ஒரு point you have to consider. That's the second point. Then draw the vectors representing the forces acting on the object. Okay, so force act pandrathu you have to given by a representation. Suppose consider this is an object and these are the forces acting on the object. These are the forces acting on the object. We have to represent it as in vector form F1, F2, F3, F4 and going on. Okay, whatever the forces may be. Finally, we want to calculate the total force, net force. Okay, here what is the net force? Net force is equal to sum of all the forces, that is F1, F2, etc. up to F5. Okay. So we are adding all these forces. This is net force. Okay. So according to Newton's second law, we are using Newton's law. Newton's law means I told you that it is second law. So we will calculate if there is acceleration. If I am considering this as an object, okay, this is our object net force. This may act as all forces in aridirka. Okay. Suppose if this body is moving, I have to find out the net force acting on it. Okay, so the net force is equal to, we know that mass into acceleration. Okay, here we will engala force in irukku, that is nothing but net force, total force acting on the body. F in irundale adu total force and the system la act pandrathu, that is mass into acceleration. If there is no acceleration, we know that what will become, if this will become zero. Okay, if acceleration is equal to zero, there is no net force. Acceleration irundichu appadina we have to find out the net force. These are the three simple steps to calculate the free body diagram. Now I will give you an example. So consider this example. A book of mass m is at rest on the table. Okay, ஒரு டேபிள் இருக்கு. அந்த டேபிள்ல we are placing a book whose mass is m. Okay, the question is, what are the forces acting on the book? Book மேல என்னென்ன forces? Okay, bookல என்னென்ன forces act ஆகுது? The next one, what are the forces exerted by the book? Book என்ன force exert பண்ணது? Draw the free body diagram for the book. Okay, then finally you draw the free body diagram. Okay, so consider this is a table and we have placed a book whose mass is m. Okay, now what are first question? What are the forces acting on the book? Okay, first we have to consider this is a book. Okay, so whatever the object may be, we know that there is a gravitational force acting on it. Okay, that is gravitational force means mass into acceleration. Okay, so in this book we know that definitely a gravitational force is acting, that is F is equal to mass into acceleration, mass m, the book's mass is m. Acceleration is acceleration of the earth, that is the acceleration due to gravity, that is g. Okay, so this book has an the book is irukku, that is force is equal to mass into acceleration. Then it is placed in a table, okay, or a frame mele adu vachirukom. So whenever we are placing it over the table, it is exerting a normal force. And the table vandha and the book mele or force exert pannum seriya, that is normal force that is exerted by the table. Okay, so these are the two forces acting on the book. Okay, book la act aagura rendu force paathina idu dhaan. ஒன்னு வந்து அந்த புக்கு கீழே வந்து எர்த் எடுத்துது, இன்னொன்னு நார்மல் போர்சஸ் எக்ஸர்டட் பை த டேபிள். ஓகே, சோ தட் இட் இஸ் ஸ்டேஷனரி. இந்த ரெண்டும் ஈக்குவலா இருக்கும், அதனால தான் அது அதுல ஸ்டேஷனரியா இருக்கு. ஓகே, சோ ஹியர் வாட் ஆர் த டூ போர்சஸ், ஒன் இஸ் த நார்மல் போர்ஸ். ஓகே, நார்மல் போர்ஸ் விச் இஸ் ஆக்டிங் அப்வர்ட். ஓகே, த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் த வாட் இஸ் த axial, this is gravity. Okay, normal force, this is acceleration due to gravity, and the force exerted by the earth. Okay, so it is given as a normal gravitational force. It can be written as gravitational force. This is called as gravitational force, which is acting downward. Idu da book mele act agra forces, book la act agra forces idu da. Okay, then this is the first part. Then what is the second one? What are the forces exerted by the book? இப்ப புக்ல இந்த ஃபோர்ஸ் ஆக்ட் ஆகுது, புக் என்ன ஃபோர்ஸ் எக்ஸர்ட் பண்ணு? We all know that. So whenever two bodies are in contact, we know that if there is an action, there will be equal and opposite reaction, right? So the second answer, second question, what are the forces exerted by the book? புக் என்னென்ன ஃபோர்ஸ் எக்ஸர்ட் பண்ணுது அப்படின்னு பாத்தீங்கன்னா, கண்டிப்பா இங்க ஒரு கிராவிடேஷனல் ஃபோர்ஸ் இருக்கு. சோ அந்த புக் என்ன பண்ணும் அப்படின்னா, இது புக்கு கீழே இழுக்குது இல்லையா, சோ அந்த புக் என்ன பண்ணும் அப்படின்னா, அதுக்கு எதிராக ஒரு ஃபோர்ஸ் கொடுக்கும், ரியாக்ஷன் ஃபோர்ஸ். திஸ் இஸ் ஆக்ஷன், இட் வில் டெவலப் அ ரியாக்ஷன் ஃபோர்ஸ், தட் இஸ் இட் வில் டெவலப் அ கிராவிடேஷனல் ஃபோர்ஸ். ஓகே, புக் எக்ஸர்ட்ஸ் கிராவிடேஷனல் ஃபோர்ஸ், தட் இஸ் அ ரியாக்ஷன் ஃபோர்ஸ். இது ஒரு ஆக்ஷன் கொடுக்குதுன்னா இது ரியாக்ட் பண்ணும், பட் இட் இஸ் இது டவுன்வர்டா இருக்கு, அது என்ன பண்ணும், அப்வர்டா இருக்கும். ஓகே, it will produce a upward gravitational force. Okay, the next one is, இங்க என்ன பண்ணுச்சு, the table is exerting a normal pressure on the book. Okay, so what happens, reaction according to Newton's third law, what is the reaction? The book will also exert a normal force on the table, but in opposite direction. So here also there is a normal force, but it is a downward force. Okay, this is the difference. ஸோ கண்டிப்பா இந்த புக் மேல ஆக்ட் ஆகிற ஃபோர்ஸ் ஒன்னு கிராவிடேஷனல் ஃபோர்ஸ், ஒன்னு வந்து நார்மல் ஃபோர்ஸ். ஸோ இங்க என்ன நடக்குது அப்படின்னா, கண்டிப்பா அந்த புக்கும் அது மேல ஒரு ஃபோர்ஸ் எக்ஸர்ட் பண்ணும். ஓகே, ஸோ அந்த அது எக்ஸர்ட் பண்ற ஃபோர்ஸ் எப்படி இருக்குன்னா, இதுக்கு ஈக்குவல் ஆகும், ஆப்போசிட் ஆகும். ஓகே, த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன், லாஸ்ட் ஒன், டிரா த ஃப்ரீ பாடி டயக்ராம். ஓகே, ஸோ ஐ டோல்ட் யூ ஆல்ரெடி, வென்எவர் வி ஆர் டிராயிங் அ ஃப்ரீ பாடி டயக்ராம், வாட் ஆர் த திங்ஸ் வி ஹாவ் டு கன்சிடர், வி ஷுட் நாட் include the force exerted by the object. Okay, object exert பண்ற force we should not calculate it. Okay, first thing is you have to consider the object as a point. Okay, then the object மேல என்னென்ன force act ஆகுது அப்படின்னு பாருங்க. First one is gravitational force, that is mg. Okay, then the force exerted by the table on the book, that is normal force. So these are the, this is book, okay. So these are the two forces acting on the book, okay. We should not include the force exerted by the book. So this is the free body diagram, okay. Clear? This is the free body diagram of this question. Hope you could understood it. I'll explain you another examples in the next part of the video. Thank you.